Bonjour mes amis, hi guys. While there is nothing wrong with desiring to be the first owner of a watch, walking into an authorized dealer, ADs as we call them, and paying sticker price on a widely available item is the fastest way to lose around 30% of your hard-earned money in seconds. Within the realm of affordable watches, only desirable limited edition pieces and certain Rolex Steel Sport watches will retain close to retail value and possibly appreciate with time. You might say, hold on, I don't want to spend 5 to 8 grand on a Rolex right now. But remember that Rolex is like money. Rather than have 5 to 10 grand in the bank, buy a Steel Sport Rolex, and not only will you enjoy one of the finest timepieces on your wrist, but you can sell it without losing and possibly with a nice gain when you get tired of it or need the cash for something else. Of course, many ADs don't have any in store or keep them for their big spenders, but you just might get lucky in smaller cities. If you ever spot a Hulk or a Daytona, jump on them. You can make immediate cash on the secondary market. God forbid you should find a brand new GMT Pepsi this summer. You might double your money right away, as it will be the hottest watch this year. Very few other brands at the moment can boast the same excitement. And in the affordable range, I can only think of some discontinued popular models like my Longines Legend Diver No Date, which trades way above its retail price, or even the price of the newer Date version now. I got it at a nice 30% discount from retail, only slightly used with the big presentation box. It was my first great deal in this watch collecting hobby, but I had to go fetch it all the way to Tokyo, which is easy for me since I go once in a while and have connections there. But you will rarely find this kind of opportunity. Having said that, you might be able to spot other interesting gaps in the market. In the low tier, I found brand new Seiko Datejust homages in a small shop in Hong Kong by pure luck. Those are sought after by Seiko fanboys. And the same story goes with this limited edition Black Series Turtle that came out recently. It was quickly bought by aficionados of the brand and scalpers wanting to make a quick buck. But I found a hole-in-the-wall store that had this beautiful specimen and offered the customary discount. It's a winner, and I could flip it easily at a profit now or in the future, undoubtedly. Staying with Seiko, I got my Saab 033 and 035 at the lowest prices on eBay, with free shipping from a local Hong Kong seller, before the rumors of a discontinuation. Watch collecting is often, as you can see, all about timing. Another example, Hamilton managed to place their beautiful pilot Day-Date in the movie Interstellar, but you would be hard-pressed to find the exact same model, which ran a basic ETA movement. The current version has a modified ETA with a longer power reserve but a slower beat rate as a result, which makes the sweep less smooth. So if you can find the original version around the $600 to $700 mark, I think that the Hollywood and discontinued factors will help the watch hold its value. Here again, the retail sticker price is over $900, but nobody should walk in a shop and pay that. You won't get much discount at an AD, so turn to eBay instead. For this kind of common mid-tier brand, it's fine to buy on eBay from reputable sellers. That means sellers with close to 100% positive feedback who sell hundreds of pieces and are happy to refund you just to preserve their rating if need be. I always look for the best deals on my watches, and the ones that I bought new, I usually bought at a discount. Even when buying at my local Seiko AD, who offers at least 15% off. Usually, I try to get 30 to 40% off list prices. For example, I got this $1,000 Hamilton GMT for $600. Deals come and go, so take your time, scan the market well, pull the trigger when you find a sweet spot. You have to gauge if a watch you like might get hard to find or will keep on being readily available in the coming months. In which case, the waiting game will be to your advantage. You just need to be opportunistic rather than impulsive. When buying used, you expose yourself to more risk. So read carefully the ads. In doubt, don't go through with the purchase and always gauge the seller's reputation. Once you've done your homework, you can make killer deals. For example, I got my Omega Aquaterra with box and papers for around half the retail price, with just a few scratches. It runs one of the finest, most rugged calibers available from any luxury watch brand. Will it ever be worth more? Probably not. Omega mass produces their watches in all sorts of colors and improves them ever so slightly every year or so. For now, I think that I have the most desirable iteration of it, and I got it at the right level. It's a keeper, but not an investment per se. Still, I can probably sell it within the coming 3 years near the price I paid for it, which is as good as you can ask for a watch these days. Should you worry about scratches? How much wear is acceptable? That's a bit up to you, but know that any watch will pick up scratches within weeks no matter how much you babysit it. I feel so much more comfortable buying a used watch and not have to worry about being the first one to scratch it. I put my first scratch on the hardex crystal of my Seiko Shogun the other day, in a very stupid way, I might add, and it really bothers me to no end. A word about the grey market. Some ADs move their stocks through non-authorized dealers, and you can find brand new watches at excellent prices, such as the Omega Speedy Pro Moonwatch. I got mine at the lowest level reached so far. I'm talking even under the prices asked on the infamous Joma Shop website. The difference is that I got the full set, including the warranty card, while Joma Shop will not provide those. For your information, I found it on Chrono 24, a much safer place to shop for luxury watches than eBay. Is it important to have box and papers? Well, it depends on the age of the watch. For something recent, it's reasonably important, as there is no reason why you shouldn't have them. For older and vintage pieces, it's not as important, but can be worth a lot if all is genuine. The thing is, boxes are easy to find, and papers and warranty cards can be faked. So you should really focus more on the watch rather than the papers. You might find a Rolex with box and original papers that had the dial and hands changed during service, or even be totally fake altogether. Beware of fake Panerai watches as well. If you can get a great deal on the watch and all looks spot on, then go for it. It's not a vintage, but I got my Omega Speedy Racing Minty without box and papers. But what would the box and papers add for me, really? It's obviously not a fake. You might argue that it could have been stolen, but the dealer is well known on eBay and has a good reputation. I wanted the watch, I got the watch, I got a good discount, even compared to the grey market. It runs cask and looks superb, so there you go. No papers, no worry. Omega will still be happy to service it when the time comes. But one more time, don't buy if the deal looks too good to be true. If you're new to this, trust me, there are very few great deals, especially when you tread on Rolex territory on eBay. Fakes are everywhere, and I had a first-hand encounter with a real con artist when looking for an Explorer 2. They'll make up really innocent stories, but you can usually feel that something doesn't add up quite quickly. Buy the seller, not just the watch. So there you go. I hope these thoughts will be useful to you. Try not to buy on impulse too often. Know what you want. Scan the market opportunistically. Try to get at least 30% off on watches that came out a few months ago, and around 15% off brand new models. And always look for great deals. If you have the guts to dive into vintage watches, build up your knowledge, take your time, make contacts with different dealers in person if possible, to discuss and get their opinions, because everyone had to start somewhere in this hobby, and I am learning every day and enjoy sharing the experience on my channel with you guys. So long, à bientôt.